So welcome to the last part of Introduction to Teamwork, where we'll be talking about time management. So first I will introduce three models. The Viking model is the first. The idea is to bring a priest along, hope for nice weather, the god's assistant, and let the wind decide where you end up. This corresponds to no time planning. Then there is the other side, the Titanic model. Try to plan from the beginning, everything down to the last detail. Set out the direction, make the plan, and stick to the plan no matter what is happening. And what will happen? Yeah. Finally, the Columbus model. Do as Columbus. Set a goal of the journey, the goal of the project. Keep check on and adjust the direction continually in order to reach the goal in question. But the idea, and that's also the main message of this presentation, is to make a plan, monitor how things are going, and adjust the plan accordingly, because there is no project where there will be no surprises on the way which has to be handled. But the plan is an instrument to make that happen. So management of time is really management of unpredictable change that will always happen via project planning and project monitoring. So project planning is really 50% thinking ahead, 25% communication, and 25% milestones. So the project plan is really a model of the project, including all of its activities, that is, the tasks, which together constitute the complete project. So how the model can be used is really to experiment with the timing and scheduling of different activities of the project to set it up so that it will work the best way possible. But it's also a yardstick to which you can measure progress and monitor the project. So by setting up milestones on the way, you know that if you don't reach your milestone, you can actually do something about it. It's also, in line with this, a basis for the regular review and update, so planning the remaining parts of the project. So the idea is not that on day one, you make a plan for the whole project and you keep it all that way. It might be that on day one, you actually do make a plan for the project, but when things are changing on the way, you need to replan for the future. So the monitoring and the constant replanning is really part of the whole time management. Of course, you can plan at different levels. So you can say that the overview, the long-term level, you have a big task and you have few milestones. And then when you get to the activity level, you can say, where are you now? And then you need to detail out the activity plan with many smaller tasks. But this can be hard or even difficult or even meaningless to do from the beginning, because you don't know the detailed activities before you get there. Of course, also a daily level, so what are we going to actually do today? This is a Gantt chart, which is just an idea. And again, the point here is not to make the Gantt chart from the beginning, but to actually plan and revise it all the time. So you set up different milestones, you realize for different reasons, that can be good reasons, you didn't make the milestone, and then you can decide what to do. You can decide we need to reduce the project scope. You can decide we need to work harder. Or you can decide that the deviation is so small that you will be able to catch up at the end. Or you might have some buffer time. From the beginning, you have allocated 2 weeks for buffer time, and you realize that being 2 days behind halfway through the project is not that bad, because you can still manage within your buffer zone. But the important thing is that when you are deviating from your original time plan, that you can actually make a decision about what to do and make a new plan that you believe in. And that is the core part of the time planning exercise. Of course, there is also the monitoring along the way. So to think about, why has some activities taken too long time? Is it something that will also impact us further? Is it really something that we should take into account in the last part of the project? Can we compensate for the delay by working harder? Is it possible to reorganize the work schedule around it, as I said also before with the buffer time? Or is it necessary to cut out some activities? And then you can make a decision about which activities you're cutting out of the project. So instead of standing 2 weeks before the deadline, as in the Viking model, and realizing that you will never be able to achieve what you wanted, you can well ahead plan to cut out this part of the project, or to reduce the scope, or to do something different. so that your product still constitutes a whole. So try to think about what are the consequences of these choices and what do you then decide to do in the groups. With these small recommendations, I hope they were useful for you in every project and in any other project you will do. This is just really a scratching in the surface when it comes to time planning. There are different methods, different models that you can look into. But the main message is to make a plan from the beginning, to monitor your plan, and then to revise your plan accordingly to organize your work in the best possible way. Thank you for listening and good luck with doing your EPIC project.